I try to conquer my patterns, and often it feels I'm glued to that. And I also have the feeling that you have to want that more than anything else, so that there is enough power just to stop the old habits. But I have no idea how it can be.
When you were really little, you knew what it was like to be happy without a reason. You didn't look for it. You just simply and easily came from that. When you desire something of a deeper nature, it isn't just that you're separate from it, that you're desiring it. Most importantly, it is that you're knowing the truth of it. You're knowing something deeper within. From within yourself, you then long for that. You desire it. The desire and the longing does two things in you. It takes you closer, and at the same time, it takes you further away. It takes you closer because what makes the longing real to you is the truth that's in it. What moves you within the longing is your own connection to what you know within you're longing for. Within the longing, you're already having it. Within the longing, you're not separate from it. And while you're not separate from it, you're relating from yourself. You're using yourself to desire that which you're already knowing the truth of. That's what gives you the experience that you're separate. Identify what you're knowing the truth of in your heart, within the longing. And then settle in what you're knowing. Relax into what you're knowing. That has you as awareness in your heart, relating to what knowing is. When you are as awareness, not just knowing the truth of something, but relaxing into what you're knowing, then you're coming from what you're knowing. When you're trying to have it, it's because you are within yourself, judging that you're separate from it. You're using your own experience in yourself to make a problem. When you're longing for it, it's because you're already connected to it. You're already relating to what you know of the truth of it. It's that relating that feeds the longing in yourself. Have just the relating. You don't need what you're using in yourself to relate to it. You were in this before you even developed yourself. It's natural to you, without the use of yourself. You don't need what is developed in yourself for you to have what you were before you developed yourself. When you go to sleep at night, you don't use how your day is developed to assist you in going to sleep. You don't need anything of what there was in your day for you to sleep. You don't need anything that is in yourself for you to go to sleep. When you go to sleep, it's because you have already left everything behind. You've relaxed into what you are before what yourself is. You do it all the time. It's natural to you. What makes it seem difficult is that you mix in what you have developed that has nothing to do with that which you desire within. You mix what you have developed as a self with your own longing within. You don't need to mix it to have it. Within the longing, you already have it. You just leave out the part you don't need. When you want to sleep, leave your day out of it. You don't need what took place in the day for you to go to sleep. You know how to go to sleep. When you go to sleep, you simply leave everything out of it. For you to be in what you're most longing for, to be in. Just enjoy leaving everything else out of it. It's like the difference between you thinking about what you know in your heart and you liking what you're knowing in your heart. When you're thinking about what you know in your heart, then you have a mix. You are knowing the truth of something in your heart, and you're using yourself to try and make that more palpable. You're using yourself to walk around it, to look at it, to form thoughts about it, using yourself to work on it. While you are instead able to just simply like what you're knowing. Liking what you're knowing puts you in it. When you're liking what you're knowing in your heart becomes filled with what knowing is. When you're thinking about what you know in your heart becomes filled with thoughts about it. When you ride a bike, to do bicycle riding, you naturally do nothing more than what is needed. You're not fiercely holding on to the handlebar. You're not doing all kinds of things in your body that have nothing to do with riding the bike. You just simply do what works. You know how to ride a bike. You don't have trying in your face. You don't have trying in your body. You simply ride your bike. You're able to apply the same in principle to your being what you first are. You're not even able to be in yourself without first having what you first are. You're always being it. And you add something to it. You don't need to add anything to it. When you think of connecting with your own being, when you think of finding your own being, what you do is you use yourself. You use yourself to look for it. You use yourself to try something. You use yourself to explore the possibility of it. You do everything other than just simply having your own being. When you're wanting to connect with your own being, you have that because you already know the truth of it. You have it in the longing. If you want to connect with your own being, make it easy. Make it immediate and easy. In making it easy, you'll naturally leave out what doesn't work and what doesn't help. When you're trying to connect with your own being, what you are being then is the trying. When you're efforting, you're being the effort. The effort then has you experiencing what you're not having of your own being. When you're liking making it really easy, you will naturally, as awareness in your heart, leave out everything that has nothing to do with your connecting with your own being. You don't understand your own being. So if you wish to connect with your own being, don't use your understanding. Don't use what isn't a part of it. The way to connect with your own being is for you as awareness to be the same as your own being. When you leave out everything that isn't directly what your own being is, then you're left residing in your own being. If you're thinking about that, then you're thinking instead of being. As soon as you are relating to being, without being dependent on a thought of that and an understanding of that, then you're being. You can have it for a moment, and as soon as you have it for a moment, then you like it from within yourself. You like it as a self, making you separate from it. Just simply leave out what doesn't do it. When you go to sit down, you don't go through great complicated effort to sit down. You know how to sit down. When you want to sit down, you simply do so. What makes it uncomplicated is that it all has form. You can see the chair, you can feel it, you can walk to it, and then simply sit. When it comes to your own interior, as awareness, you're also able to include something that isn't a part of what being is. You're able to include it because it doesn't have the form that you're used to outside of yourself. So then you easily begin to mix because you can. You're able to include yourself in what your own being isn't, making accessing beingness terribly difficult. when you go to sit down, you don't do strange and complicated things to do so. You simply sit because you already know how. In accessing your own being, you simply do so. You already know what your own being is. You're not understanding what you're knowing. And you use the lack of understanding, and you turn that into a lack of knowing. So you convince yourself that you don't know what your own being is, that you don't know how to find it, that you don't know how to come from it. And you use every way you can to try and reach it, making it more difficult. You are a being that has a self. For you to access your own being, you don't need yourself. You don't need everything you have for you to be what you are. When you're longing to access your own being, you already have it. Leave yourself out of it, and as awareness, you are all in. Whatever you grab hold of as awareness of yourself to help, then you're holding that. In holding that, you're being that. While it's difficult, make it easy. In making it easy, you'll be direct in it. In making it easy, you go straight to it. You don't use anything that isn't a part of it. When you go through a walk in nature, you're relating directly to the beingness of nature. That's what has you experiencing what nature is. It's easy for you to do it because you can see what you're walking in. It is that easy with your own being. The difference is that you can't see it. So you'll naturally include what has nothing to do with it. You'll include thoughts, desire, and effort. When you go for a walk through nature and you're experiencing the beingness of nature, your own experience of your body is different. You shift to a different level of your body as soon as you're walking in nature. As soon as you leave your walk in nature, you shift back to another level of your body, one that has more to do with the function of yourself. Your own being is your first nature. It's what you use to go for a walk in nature. It's how you find the same in what nature is. When you go for a walk in nature, you are experiencing what nature is. And you're not doing something to be able to do that. You know how to go directly to it. You're not doing strange and interesting things to access it. You don't confuse it, because nature has form. It's outside of you, and you use what you are as a being, to identify with it. So you're able to directly be one with it and have it. You're able to just enjoy something that you actually can't even see. When you're enjoying nature, it isn't because first what you see. It's because of what you're having within while seeing it. You're able to be what that within is without having to see it. You're able to be in what your own being is without having to see it, without having to think it, without doing anything in yourself to be in it.